I'm Will Sable-Courtney, and these are our picks for the 10 most notable new automobiles to go on sale in America in 2019. First up, our top recommendation. The Jeep Gladiator is this year's editor's pick. The new Jeep Gladiator proves the car maker could combine a pickup truck and a Wrangler into a single vehicle that has the best attributes of both. It's a four-door Wrangler with a stretched-out wheelbase and a 5-foot metal bed affixed to the back of it. All of the Wrangler's iconic class-leading equipment carries over. And the Gladiator is nearly as capable off-road as its SUV sibling. But it can tow far more and is much more pleasant on road. It can be optioned up past $60,000, but you can snag a well-equipped one for around $45,000. That's keep in mind for an off-roader, a 5-seat family car, a convertible, and a pickup truck all in one for that same price. It's kind of hard to see that as anything but the deal of the year. Every new version of the 911 keeps Porsche at the head of the sports car pack. The new 911's cabin is decidedly high-tech, packed with screens and a toggle switch shifter. The extra-wide rear houses a turbocharged version of the traditional flat-six engine, mated to a new 8-speed dual-clutch transmission. Though it's moving solidly into Grand Tourer territory, the 911 remains one of the most iconic sports cars. And for good reason. If you can, you should. This electric crossover is exceptionally well-engineered, delivering its own brand of sporty performance. Audi delivered the first electric crossover to offer a truly premium experience and high-end build quality, even if the e-tron's 204-mile range doesn't quite compete with EV SUVs from Tesla and Jaguar. It's perfect for those who want Audi style and SUV substance, but prefer plugs to gas pumps. After outlasting and outdoing its competitors, Zero Motorcycles has delivered the latest evolution in electric motorcycles, the jaw-droppingly sporty Zero SRF, which is fully formed and ready to run. In addition to the whisper-quiet motor, which rockets the bike from 0 to 60 in under 2 seconds, the handling is impressively smooth. It has selectable drive modes that make a big difference. In eco mode, regenerative braking noticeably boosts the bike's range. There's also a rapid charge option, which juices the battery to 95% in an hour. After nearly 20 years, the G-Wagon is totally new. The hot rod G63 version is as fast as a muscle car, comfortable as a luxury sedan, and capable as any SUV. It's the ultimate automotive multi-tool. The new G-Class's cabin is roomy and comfortable, the widescreen dashboard and center console laden with modern tech. And, like those before, the G-Wagon also boasts serious off-road cred. On top of all that, the G63 version packs a 577 horsepower turbocharged V8 and will hit 60 miles per hour in under 4 seconds. This in spite of its 5,842 pound curb weight and brick-like aerodynamics. The One is Bird's first scooter made for purchase, rather than for its urban scooter sharing business. It features tubeless wheels to prevent flats and a steel-reinforced aluminum chassis. GPS and Bluetooth connectivity let you use your phone to lock and track your scooter. Plus, owners are eligible for deals on Bird's shared scooter network. In top trim form, both the Ram 2500 and 3500 are as tech-packed and comfortable as a luxury sedan. Heavy-duty pickup truck owners want more than just maximum capability. They also want the same comforts common to other vehicles. These trucks deliver with luxury-level cabins and top tech. The giant Ram 3500 cranks out 1,000 pound-feet of torque, giving it enough towing capability to pull a small herd of elephants. After a heavily anticipated 17-year absence, the Toyota Supra delivers on the hype. The new Supra, developed in partnership with BMW, packs a rear-wheel drive platform and a turbocharged inline-six that seems to make far more than its alleged 335 horses. There's no manual transmission, and the steering is a little light on feedback. But Toyota chose not to let the perfect be the enemy of the good here, and it delivered a great car as a result. When a car costs as much as a house, it has to work pretty hard to justify its price tag. The Bentley Continental GT V8, however, makes that job look easy. Slide into the leather-laden cabin, fire up the twin-turbo 8-cylinder engine, and the Conti takes off like a shot, hitting 60 miles an hour just 4 seconds into its run to 198 miles per hour. all while weighing 2.5 tons with you on board, of course. Indian's FTR 1200 is its first all-new bike in half a decade, and draws inspiration from the Minnesota company's rich history in flat track racing. When designing this bike, engineers started from scratch, optimizing airflow into the potent V-twin by placing the airbox directly above the engine, where the fuel tank would go. That results in a lower center of gravity for superior agility.